Hey guys, good to see everybody. Good to see everybody's faces. Obviously, I can't see yours, but you can see mine. I haven't seen everybody in a while. So we're gonna have a little bit of a devotion time here today. Talk about some worship. And then we're gonna have a little devotion, and then we're gonna have a little time of prayer. So if everybody could turn to Psalm 100, I'm gonna read through the whole chapter, and then I'm just gonna kind of focus on one verse. So let's just start reading. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. I'm going to focus here on my devotion here a little bit about more towards verse 4, entering into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. That's kind of where I want to kind of go with this time of devotion. So obviously we've been in unprecedented times. Things have been happening as of the past couple months that we haven't seen. And so a lot of things are up in the air. People's jobs, people's livelihoods, families are kind of in a place of worry because of some of the financial situations and things of that sort. And so with that being said, that leads our lives to be unstructured. Some people have lost their jobs. Some people are still working like normal, and some people are working remote. And so with that being said, things have changed in people's lives that we might have had a good routine going. I know I had a great routine going. And so with all this happening, my routine just got thrown out the window. So it's been kind of a restructuring of my routine, my daily life. And so with that being said, I want to talk about the structure of the tabernacle. I know there's a lot of great plans out there. A lot of people talk about praying through the tabernacle. I just want to talk and highlight a few things, and hopefully this helps you guys if you guys are struggling with kind of getting a good structure to prayer or worship or just your daily life in general. And so when we talk about the tabernacle, there's just a few doorways. There's a few entry points. So the first one is into the gates, into the outer courts. And then there's another one that goes into the inner court, the holy place. And then the third one is into the holiest of holies. And that's where we want to strive to be, into the throne room. That's where the El Shekinah glory of God resided. And so we want to kind of talk about these, highlight these. So into the outer courts, it can represent thanksgiving. And into the inner courts, it can represent praise. And then the worship, or the holies of holies, isn't kind of mentioned in the scripture. However, that should kind of, that's where we want to go. That's where we want to be, ultimately. And so when we talk about getting into the tabernacle, there's a lot of other things that you pass through it. And so we talk about thanksgiving, just getting your heart ready. It is what this is all about, is getting your heart ready to get into the presence of God and seeing him on a day-to-day basis to kind of get your worries, all your cares off your heart and put your focus on God. And so this thing is, or this plan here, the tabernacle plan, is all about getting yourself into a place of your heart being ready to come before God. There's always a structure to this. Otherwise, we would never see God. We would never get into his presence because he is holy. He is standing. He is a part of the holy ground. And so what I want to talk about here also is when we talk about the whole, what's going on, is we're not all alone, and so we're all in this together. And so this is something that I've actually focused on throughout this whole time. And so we talk about let's go back to the gate, the gates, the gate of Thanksgiving, into the outer courts. This was going to represent an attitude of gratitude, being thankful. Hey, I'm walking, I'm breathing, just for the simplest things. It doesn't have to be for the grand scheme of things. Hey, I got this nice new car. It can just be for having a good meal or whatever, just being thankful. And then when we kind of get into the next region of the getting into the inner courts, that's just having a heart of praise, getting that garment of praise. And that can help with so many things like the spirit of heaviness, depression, anxiety, worry, all of these things that pop up when we talk about this situation with COVID. There's so many things that have come into our mind, trying to attack our emotions and all that other good stuff. And so what all this kind of boils down to is getting closer to God, so God can perform miracles in terms of our emotions and all that stuff, so we can have a spirit of peace. And so when we talk about all that, after all that said and done, one example of a person that just kind of fell down in worship was Job. He had a pretty bad day. He lost everything, and he was a very blessed man. But the first thing he did after it was all said and done is he just fell on his face and he worshiped. He came before God and said, "Hey, have mercy on me." What he did was he just turned away from all of what was actually happening. He turned away from the situation and he put his focus on God. That's exactly what the church did, I believe. After COVID hit, the quarantine, I believe the church came together. It rallied together, and it came to a place of prayer and fasting and putting our focus on God and not what's going on outside, not what our situation is, which is what we need to keep our focus on, not just as a church as a whole, but in our individual lives. Get back to my notes here. Even though we haven't necessarily seen the end result of the blessing, like we can see in Job's result quite yet, we know that God's going to provide. God, it's in his nature to heal. It's in his nature to deliver. With that all being said, I just want to encourage everybody to get into a place of prayer, get into a place of worship, and hopefully those steps of being thankful and praising God can help somebody get closer to God throughout all this. I want to encourage everybody. We can't fall back on our relationship with God just because of our circumstances. We need to push through. We can see what happens to Job. He didn't fall back on his relationship with God. He pushed through. It was a struggle, but he pushed through. God gave him the strength to push through. And so what I want to do here today is I just want to end it with prayer. I want to encourage everybody to pray along with me. Lord Jesus, we want to give you all the glory, honor, and praise. Lord Jesus, we want to put our focus on you throughout all this COVID stuff and then what's happening in our world. Lord Jesus, people are dying. People are hurting. Families are in a place of struggle. They're in a place of worry. We want to pray, Lord Jesus, that your spirit of peace and understanding, oh God, can fall on our hearts and our minds, Lord Jesus, and help us get through this situation, oh Lord. Help us to grow in our walk with you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Have mercy on us. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, hey, thanks, guys. I appreciate you joining us today and having a little bit of time to devote.